Hey everybody, what is up for the rock fam? Thank you guys for joining me in this video. This is the final video of 2021. We're here. This isn't the final one talking about 2021, so stay tuned for one second. But this year has been absolutely nuts, so I want to thank you guys so much, each and every one of you who has hit that subscribe button, followed on Instagram, leaving comments, and hitting those like buttons and doing all that. Guys, it's been awesome getting to know some of you and just kind of building this community. Thank you so much for everything through this year. It's been absolutely crazy. I think there's been like something like 180 videos in 2021, which is absolutely insane to me. I had a lot more time at the beginning of the year, and I guess I was posting videos almost every day. So every other day on average, you guys got a new video here on the channel throughout 2021, which is insane. Definitely hasn't been that much recently, but this is top 10 of Q4. It's crazy. This year has gone by so fast. Stay tuned. Probably next week will be my top 10 of 2021. So we'll be doing that into the new year. Thank you guys so much for joining me. It's a pleasure. Let's hop into this. We got a really crazy list to end off the year for Q4. Coming in at number 10 is Buried Above with their debut self-titled album, Buried Above. This is a new hard rock project, very reminiscent to me of kind of that 2010 era, like Tooth and Nail. You know, you got like Sent by Ravens, I Am Empire, Write This Down. You know, that kind of sound is what we're getting a bit here. In a more modern sense, I would say this actually fits very well with Rockfest Records, kind of that sound that they go for. So whether you like that or not, give this one a shot. If I'm not mistaken, this album was produced by Andrew Stanton from Disciple. And it also actually features Josiah Prince, also a Disciple, Don Michelle of Fireflight, Josh Bramlett of The Protest, Matt Baird of Spoken. Like, there's some big names behind this one, and the quality speaks for itself. It's a very solid debut. The sun will rise when nations fall. Before our eyes, these kings will crawl. And side by side, we will break the night, and we will rise. Wake up, there's something hidden between the lines. A silver sun will rise. Whoa, above and shadowing every... At number 9 is another newer Christian hardcore band called Unworthy. They released their new EP, In the Face of Death, and I actually had the pleasure of working with these dudes a little bit on the EP. I got to do the visualizers, which you might have seen. We dropped a couple of those videos, so it was a pleasure working with these guys, getting to hear this EP a little bit early. They really stepped it up on this one compared to their earlier work. The production was much better, and cover art looks good. Everything around this, just super solid Christian hardcore. This is a crazy one. Maniacal Entropic Discordium. Hold on. Maniacal Entropic Discordium. This is the new full-length album from Symphony of Heaven on Rottweiler Records. Maniacal Entropic Discordium. I think I got that right. So these guys dropped a new full-length 12-song album. It clocks in at an hour and 18 minutes. There's some downtime in there. I think it's not a hidden track, but there's like a couple minute span of just silence on it. Anyways, it's over an hour long. It's long. Really awesome work from these guys. It's actually a collection. I'm pretty sure that almost all these songs were actually released in pairs throughout the year, kind of as like double singles. And so this is the collection. I think there's probably a few new songs on here, and they just brought it all together, full-length album. That being said, the one issue I have with this album is actually the production. I mean, it's blackened death metal. It's gonna sound a little raw, but just from track to track, like every couple of tracks, it sounds just a hair different, like they recorded it and everything at a different time, which is hard to get around that. But there was a couple times where it was very noticeable, like the volume, I think from tracks 2 to 3 or something like that, was like one was way louder than the other. That's my only issue. Other than that, the songwriting is pretty sick. This definitely isn't my general go-to genre, for those of you who know me. These guys doing something a little bit different, and definitely something a little bit different for me, and I really enjoy it. I dug it. That comes in at number 8. I have 4 honorable mentions that I wanted to mention in this video. I think we're just going to do it all now because I don't generally show a preview of them, but we're just going to list them all out right now. Honorable mention number 1, Inborn Tendency with their EP Godkiller, debut EP Godkiller. Second best album art of the year, in my opinion, on my Instagram feed. If you guys watch that, my top 10 cover arts of 2021. It's a thought-provoking image. Visually, it looks cool. Like, it's got really good color usage and all that. Overall, 4-song EP, very solid. Production's a little bit raw because it's kind of more in the kind of like death metal side of things. But overall, very good. I actually had these guys on the channel with one of their singles. We had the lyric video. So thank you, Inborn Tendency, for taking part this year on For The Rock. Next up, we have the new EP, When We Leave, from Hard Look. It's Christopher Johnson's solo project. It started out more kind of like industrial metal, hard rock kind of blend of stuff. And this one, he took it a little bit different and went for a little bit more of a death metal infused industrial. I'm kind of just throwing up genres here, but definitely a darker tone, and production has improved, art's on point, like everything about this one was definitely his best work to date. Also, kind of in the same circles, Jared Esposito, his solo album, Fire and Wrath, bringing in some 7 strings, I think, made this album a lot heavier than his previous work. Definitely went full on, kind of like metalcore vibes with this one. Dug it. It was a good listen. So, guys, go check out that, Fire and Wrath from Jared Esposito. And last but not least, Covenant, the new band from New Zealand. If you're searching them up online, Covenant NZ for New Zealand, there's a space and then NZ. Find them on Spotify. And they got a sick new self-titled EP. And yeah, it's awesome. It's kind of brutal and heavy. The only thing is production, it's very full ambient sound, but almost too much that it's caught a lot of that like spacey reverby noise going on that it fills it out, but it also drowns out the punch of the production. But overall, super sick debut, and always welcoming new bands and artists into the scene. These guys are one of the newest, so go and check it out. I believe their EP is also available for a free download on their Bandcamp as well. All right, number 7. Let's get back into the main list here. We're going to bring it down for a couple. A little bit less crazy. Amongst Wolves with their new full-length, first full-length? Hashtag Choose to Live. I love the messaging that these guys do. They got a little bit of metal influence in them, but definitely more of kind of like this hard rocky pop blend. I have had a couple of their stuff featured on the channel here as well, so thank you guys for taking part in that as well. Amongst Wolves, I've fallen in love with these guys over this last year. It's been awesome to see them finally put this full thing together. Awesome tracks like Defender. Yeah, go give this one a listen. It's a pleasant time for sure. You're my defender. Royal Diadem, Jesus Overall. This is the solo project of John Osborne from Diatheke, and he put together a super solid hard rock metal worship album. Jesus Overall, it's such an awesome album. Another artist who took part in being a part of this channel over the last year. We had a lyric video and some reactions for Royal Diadem as well. So go and give this one a listen. Hopefully it'll bless your walk with the Lord. We bow and cry out holy. Tend to our pain, your life is gain. The Lamb of God was slain. In you forever we stand. Your glory has no end. Let us gather. Number 5, War of Ages with their new EP, Rima. I always wanted to say Rima, but I looked up the pronunciation with Google and it says Rima. So we'll go with Rima. Sick artwork. Actually, I have it right here like I planned it. Guys, War of Ages, Rima, look at that. Absolutely sick, amazing artwork. Face Down release. Face Down absolutely killed it this year with their releases, the few that did manage to come out. And this was a sick EP. It was only 4 songs, which was a little bit disappointing. I was hoping, you know, at least 5. Come on, guys. Yeah, it felt a little short. It was a really solid collection of songs. Normally, War of Ages would probably be higher up on my list, but they get right in that middle for this one, just because the 4 songs, they're really solid. They're well done. These guys are masterful at what they do, but I just felt like the overall package kind of fell beneath the stuff coming up. So stay tuned for that. Just Number 4, Relent with their new full-length Heavy, their second release on Rockfest Records. These guys bring kind of like that new metal vibe, something in the vein of Love and Death. And this was almost the album that I was expecting Love and Death to be, which was just a little bit more heavy than what they ended up bringing earlier in the year. And yeah, I really dug it. Super crazy sounds going on. They got the rap rock in there mixed with the new metal. And they bring heavy stuff, good message. Definitely a crazy release. You got to go check it out if you haven't. The haunting goes, the death in me subsides. Number 3, we have Idle Threat with their full-length album, Blurred Visions. These guys released this on Tooth & Nail Records. And this, I have to say, it's kind of the general consensus going around online that this is probably the best Tooth & Nail Records release in a number of years. Very reminiscent of where they were a decade ago. You know, overall, if you guys don't know, like, Tooth & Nail, Solid State, they're not Christian labels anymore. It's not like that. There are Christian bands on them, and they still do that, but these guys kind of stick away from that label a little bit, so I'm not trying to put the Christian label on them, but the overall messaging of their album, and even you know, listening to interviews with these guys, like who they are as people, like Christianity is a big part of their lives, and as it should be if you are a Christian. This album is super sick. There's a lot to go on here. It wasn't my absolute favorite thing to come out this year or on this quarter, as you can see, but definitely dig it. It's refreshing. It's something a little bit different. It's got like this like post-hardcore mixed with kind of more modern rock stuff vibe going on. They have some really heavy moments on this. This is borderline something that would be on Solid State, but I guess it's just got that little bit more of a rock edge to it overall. Yeah, overall, this was a really cool surprise treat, and I'm glad it came out.
Longing to see anything that was been laid in front of me.
All right, number two. You guys are probably trying to figure out. You think you know my number one. Most of you are probably thinking that my number two is my number one, but that's not how we do it here at For the Rock. Hellbent by Impending Doom. Yes, this is my number two release of the quarter. Super sick to finally have it. It was a surprise early drop. You know, it wasn't scheduled till mid-January, but it actually came out in November? Sorry, time's blurring so much right now. They dropped the first single, Satanic Panic, and I think it was supposed to be time for the second single, and then they just dropped the whole EP. It was crazy to get it early, but I think it lived up to the hype. It was a continuation of what they were doing with the Sin and Doom Volume 2, which is the album that made me an Impending Doom fan. Since they dropped the Sin and Doom Volume 2, I've been looking forward to new stuff from them. I actually was like excited because Sin and Doom Volume 2 I loved through and through. It was a little bit more accessible to me than some of their older stuff. But yeah, I'm a fan now. Hellbent is super exciting time for this to drop, and yeah, it lives up to the hype that I had on it, for sure. Bloodlines with their new EP, Havel. Guys, this was such a special release, I think, for our scene. And just for everybody right now, it's refreshing. It's one of those ones that came out. I'm just going to say it now. If you guys aren't following me on Instagram, go do that at 4.the.rock. This is my cover art of the year. This is absolutely hands down the favorite cover that I have seen this year. Mind-blowingly good. Overall, super sick EP, 5 songs from Bloodlines. Yeah, it's just a super worshipful EP. It's refreshing. It's something that's got the quality in the production of the music, but also of the artwork. My favorite label, Facedown. A little bit biased here, but you know, you combine those with worshipful lyrics in a time that a lot of bands, especially Christian bands, are leaning into a lot of stuff. Like, I mean, it's fair. It's metal. You're going to be going into a lot of that deep imagery, dark subjects, hard subjects. And that is totally fair. And going through the last couple of years, there's just been a crazy amount of stuff that's gone on. And so when you get a band like Bloodlines coming in and just dropping, you know, heavy worship music, especially, and also Royal Diadem earlier in the list, it's just refreshing. It's awesome to see, and I really love these songs. There is a cool collection of songs, and I think it deserves the number one spot for the quarter.
Yahweh! Let your voice be heard! I will spend my days declaring your name! I will suffer! All for the sake! All for the sake of your word!
The flower has to fade, but I know that your word remains.
Let me know down below what you guys thought. Of course, these are just my opinions. I guess I didn't really mention it at the beginning, but I mention it now so nobody complains. That these are just my opinions. It's kind of a mix between what I actually thought, how good something was production-wise, songwriting-wise, and actually just how much I liked it, and, you know, throw it all in. Go and check out everything on this list. It's not, it's the reason why this list even exists is just to highlight some of the stuff that you should go check out, and so that means all of it, even the number 10s, even the honorable mentions. Go and check out these artists. Go find something you like. Go support them with your money. And maybe spread the word around online. Get the word out about these artists if you really do care and like them. And hopefully this video helps them with in the same way. Thank you guys so much for joining me. It's been absolutely massive this whole entire year. It's been a pleasure. And yeah, have a happy new year. Merry Christmas. Even though that's past, but yeah, we will see you in 2022. Peace and God bless.